my script was to show that the Lord of Muhammad, one of the gods you worship,
yeah,
is Jibril, because
where
he's sitting on the throne of
Allah. Who's sitting on them?
In the throne.
Everyone sits on his own throne. So God is not the only one.
Doesn't Elizabeth sit on her throne?
We're not talking about humans.
Muslims worship more than one god. Tawhid means unification.
No.
Jibril is on the throne of Allah, one god.
No.
Allah is another god.
No, no,
and
no.
The Kaaba stone is another god.
Okay.
They are polytheists.
Brother. Let me ask you a question. The Bible that she reads, does it talk about Islam? The Bible she reads, does it talk about Islam? Talks about her beliefs. So
therefore,
Let me tell you something. If your Quran attacks her belief, she has the right to defend her belief. She doesn't have to talk about Christianity. She can defend her faith any way she wants.
How she defend? How she defend by attacking Islam? Or by showing? Or by showing that her belief is right?
No. Because if someone attacks you, you can attack the faith back.
Why she not believe in that her belief is good?
It's not your criteria.
Why she not believe in that? Why she not believe in that her belief is good?
Because if your book attacks her faith, she has the.
We're not attacking. My book asking me to respect her belief. My neighbor is Christian. I grew up with Christian in Egypt, and I am Muslim.
If she believes,
I have no problem with any Christian.
Yeah, but if your
book
mentions Christianity and says that they fabricate meaning to. To Jesus, that they make that's called slandering. Therefore, she's making a lie. Therefore, that means you're making a slander.
Listen,
against her.
If you're religious, if you're Christian, religious, loving your deen, and you come to place like that, you should do da'wah to your religion. You should invite people to be Christian, but you don't do that.
Wait. Let me tell you.
Okay. So you're attacking people worshiping the same God like you, but you don't attack people worshiping cows, worshiping animals.
This is what we call Speaker's Corner. No one can dictate to anyone else what they want to come
exactly.
And talk
you
about.
Can't talk
if
anything.
Someone wants to talk about capitalism, no one can come and say talk about communism. If they want to talk about Islam, they can talk about Islam.
Who don't have any religion?
Speaker's Corner. Someone can talk about whatever they want. It's not down to anyone else to say you can come to Speaker's Corner and talk about this. If they want to talk about my faith, they can do it. If someone talks about Buddhism and they're not a Buddhist, that's what up to their opinion. But this is what Speaker's Corner is about.
I have the right also to defend my religion, innit?
Because
all the time you're attacking me, so I have the right.
But you can't come
and
here.
And my way is
any
Muslim did this, now he defending his religion like that.
That's fine.
Because we're not ordered to fight with you. Even if you cast my God in my religion, I have to leave you know that?
Okay.
I have to just stop talking with you, that's it.
That's fine.
Yeah,
but what I'm saying to you
is this.
People cannot come to Speaker's Corner and dictate what other people speak about, even if it goes against your belief.
I just don't understand.
Let me finish my point. People come and say, for example, DCCI, they talk about Islam and not enough about Christianity. If your faith is attacking their faith, they have every single right to come and attack what they believe is attacking them. No one can come and say, you don't come. You have to worry about
it.
That's your lie. You can't believe that. You can't believe that.
Do not lie to us. We're not as gullible as your audience. Surah 9:29-9:31. Tell Allah says, destroy the Christians.
Can you speak Arabic to talk about Quran?
I don't need to speak.
Are you qualified? Are you qualified to talk about Quran?
Listen,
can you speak
listen,
Arabic?
Sir.
You can't.
Listen,
you have no right to talk about Arabic.
I have a right to talk about whatever.
Yeah, you have the right, but
you are not.
I am not.
You don't understand.
I am not Timmy.
The Quran says in 9:29, destroy the Christians and the Jews.
Liar.
He's using what they call
liar,
and he has no honor or respect for himself. Allah says, may.
That's what he taught you.
So what is the context? Where did you get that in the Bible? Where in the Bible does it say love thy neighbor?
You don't know, but you're quoting it.
Listen,
there we go.
Listen.
That's the Islamic ignorance.
What's the Christian did in Serbia?
What's the Christian did in Serbia and Kosovo? What? He killed the million.
Now,
Jamel from
Surah 929 to Serbia.
I've held him to account and he's embarrassed because he knows he cannot lie to me. And I will not be strong armed with people.
I can't take you serious because you don't know
Arabic. I don't take you serious.
You don't know Arabic.
Because you don't know what you're talking about.
We don't care. Thank you very much.
A woman is helping him. So this is the Islamic cowardice.
Yeah.
So this is a coward. A woman has to rescue him from the reality of a conversation.
No, because you're not qualified to
talk to me.
Because you're not qualified to talk about Quran. Because you don't know what the meaning of Arabic.
I don't need to know the meaning of Arabic.
You have to know what is the meaning of Arabic.
No. So now you've heard. You heard it from a Muslim's mouth. He's shown you that the dialogue of the Quran cannot be understood in English. So if you read a Sahih International, Yusuf Ali, a Muslim that says he's been to an Islamic school, has confirmed that unless you speak the Quran in Arabic, you're learning nothing.
We have a conversation. We don't talk to peasants.
Peasants. So this is someone calling me a peasant.
You called him a Satan.
And you blame him.
I'm going to show you the evidence.
I like this guy. Okay. So now repeat the story. So this is for the international audience, for those that have an educated mind and ready to listen. Sahih al-Bukhari, 1125.
Sahih al-Bukhari is not Quran.
Hold on.
It's not orders from God. It's someone who wrote it. He can do mistakes.
So now,
he's the prophet.
So now,
he's human like me and you. Okay, he can do his mistakes.
I'll let him talk. Another epic fail from this guy. This is a hadith with the Quran verse inside it.
No. There is no hadith Quran verse inside it. Quran is the orders of Allah. Hadith is the prophet
said. This man has thus got no knowledge. So now I'm going to read it. Gabriel did not come to the prophet for some time. And so one of the Quraysh women said, his Satan has deserted him. So came the divine revelation. Now read the Quran, 93:1-3. By the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord Muhammad has neither forsaken nor hated you. So this is the confirmation Allah is Satan. And we'll go into more. Surah 53:1-23.
I'm going to explain it to you because you can't do Arabic.
Sorry.
So you don't understand.
This is my monologue.
You know you're going to be embarrassed.
No, you know you're going to be embarrassed.
What verse is that?
Show me what verse. Tell me what verse.
You're going to
understand. Stick around.
So now,
bro, you make a joke, so you want to talk.
Yeah, because I don't take it seriously.
You
want to
talk,
yeah?
You want to talk, yeah?
So now, I'm going to read the so-called noble Quran.
Okay?
Now, the statement we made is that, and I would like Brother Hudson to read it again. So we're going to do it in order so that people are educated to the truth of this religion.
Gabriel did not come to the prophet for some time, and so one of the Quraysh women said, Satan had deserted him. So came the divine revelation. Thus, this is the Quran. By the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord, O Muhammad, has neither forsaken you nor hated
this
you.
Now, some people say that Muhammad's Lord is not Gabriel. So we'll go into the which translation? Sahih International. And we're going to go into an hadith that will show you the more confusion. When Muslims talk about Tawheed, we believe in one God, but Tawheed means unification. And if you know that the Kaaba stone is one God because it's going to have eyes and ears one day and do a testimony, the Quran is eternal, that makes it second God. Hold on, this is my narrative.
No, don't interrupt.
Chill.
Okay, go on.
Patience is a good virtue.
Why do you have to die?
Patience is a virtue. I'm explaining my point for the audience. This is unfortunately.
Well, the audience here, explain.
No, you are not in dialogue with me.
You just come in. We need a discussion. Forget them. Yeah, read it.
So, and Jibreel was the one that brought the revelation. So now we'll go into why Jibreel is the third God, the unholy trinity of the Quran. By the star when it descends, your companion has not strayed nor is he erred, nor does he speak of his own inclination. It is but a revelation revealed, taught to him by one of intense strength, Gabriel, one of soundness, and rose to his true form, which, while he was in the higher part of the horizon, then he approached and descended, and was at a distance of 2 bow lengths or nearer, and he revealed to his servant. So the servant of
Jibril is Muhammad. That is one epic fail.
You did read it properly.
Hold on,
no,
hold on.
No, you didn't read it properly.
What he
revealed. No, you didn't read it properly.
Can you
read it properly. Jibril is a messenger.
Jibril sitting on the throne of Allah. We're going to, like I said, these guys are jumping ahead of the time. They don't know what we're trying to make.
Where is he?
So don't make the point.
Which one?
I was again called and I looked, but okay. I saw nothing, which an Arabic scholar has confirmed.
No, it's not true.
I saw Jibril, peace be upon him.
Yeah.
So why is Jibril or Gabriel or whatever sitting on the throne of Allah?
That's not the throne.
It's not the throne.
He's a liar.
What did he say?
Oh, this gentleman, I like you. He's the one that said Allah is not our God. This is the man. Remember?
Yeah,
109. Surah 109. Get him on camera. You're a good man. I respect you. Yeah. There you go. That's what I want. Thank you, sir.
Do you agree with him?
I respect you for your honesty.
What do you want him to read? He wants to
read. Script was to show that the Lord of Muhammad, one of the gods you worship,
yeah,
is Jibril, because he's sitting on the throne of
Where's
Allah.
Where's the throne?
Now read the
read it. Go
now
read
the hadith. I'm going to give you this.
Should I read Where's it? The throne? Should I read it out? From the green, yeah? I was again called, and I looked about but saw nothing. I was called again and raised my head, and there on the throne in the open atmosphere, he, i.e. Gabriel, peace be upon him, was sitting. I began to tremble on account of fear. Sitting. Where would he sit?
Open atmosphere. Open atmosphere.
So what are you saying that means?
Hold on. Open atmosphere.
So what is it a throne or is it not?
Is there only one throne in the world?
No, my friend. Hold on.
Is there only one throne?
Hold on. Let's reason. Is it a throne or is it not? Make your point. Right. So and who's sitting on it? Yeah, and then that's what he's saying.
No, but this is not the throne of God.
Hold on,
this is not the throne of God.
Oh, so there's more than one throne.
No, no, is there only one throne in the world?
Okay, well, you explain to me.
No, one second. Now, if I sit on the throne here,
my friend,
if you sit on the throne here,
you're a man, it doesn't mean
anything. No, hold on. How many thrones? Let's flash this out. How many thrones are there? Is there only one throne? Thrones of God. Does God have a throne and does he sit on it?
No, he doesn't sit on it.
Okay, where is God and what? What's the relationship with Allah and his throne? What's the relationship with Allah and his throne? Does Allah have a throne or not, and does he sit on it?
Well, it's not for him to sit on it.
So what is the throne and Allah? What is the relationship? My friend, it's not what he said here. My friend, you're making this up.
Okay,
come on.
Hold on.
My friend, you're making this up.
How did you know this is the throne of God, by the way?
This guy's saying Allah
does not have a throne. My friend, didn't you see what I read?
And they're on a throne.
Yeah?
Here, by the way, they've added the. On a throne.
Yeah, okay, so, let me ask you then. Who's sitting on the throne?
One second. Now, if I say to you, I saw you sitting on the throne, does that mean you're sitting
on the throne? No, my friend, you're not comparing like with like. I'm asking you about this particular context.
Okay, where's the throne of God? Where's the throne of God?
Hold on, my friend, hold on. You're saying he's wrong,
yeah,
so now this is your chance to prove him wrong.
Yeah, exactly.
You've got to do it intentionally.
Where does it say the throne of God here?
My friend.
Where does it say the throne of God?
Oh, so Jibril sits on the throne as well. Is that what you're saying? Thank you. So now he's proved my point. Islam has many gods. The Kaaba is
No,
this is your words. Jibril has a throne, Allah has a throne, and the Kaaba stone has its own temple.
Hold on, we're not talking about a human throne, like a king or a queen. We're talking about a heavenly throne, a deity,
of a god. It's not. That's another Muslim
claim. What throne is this?
My friend, you keep asking the same question.
No, what's the throne of this?
I'm asking you, in order to answer that question, you have to answer me this.
I answered you.
Does God have a throne, and is there more than one throne?
There is more than one throne. Yeah, there is more than one throne.
Yeah, there's more than one god. You have more than one god.
There's more than one throne.
No, what is it? Throne per God?
My friend, you're not very...
No, hold on. Is it throne per God?
I'm asking a very simple question. Relax. I'm not accusing you. I'm asking a question.
That's why I'm asking you, because you seem a surprise.
No.
Here, this brother here, so we've established the throne of God.
Established then that there is more than one throne and that Allah is not the only one that has a throne.
There's 100,000 thrones in the world.
Who's sitting on them? Everyone sits on his own throne. So God is not the only one.
Doesn't Elizabeth sit on her throne?
We're not talking about humans. No, my friend.
Come on.
What is this?
You can't. You're on an epic fail. This doesn't work. You're making yourself. Remember, you're on camera. You're on camera, sir.
We're not talking about a human king or queen. We're talking about deity.
Okay. Hold on. Does angels sit on thrones?
No.
I'm asking you.
Yes.
Oh.
What's
the problem? In Islam.
Okay. In Islam.
What's the problem?
So, what's the problem?
Asking for evidence. Where's the evidence? Show me a surah. Show me a surah. No, not this one. No, show it in the Quran. In the Quran.
It doesn't have to be in there.
No, it has to. That's the book of Allah.
How do you know anything without that? According to your faith,
it's the word of Allah. Show us that.
Does the Quran here show you everything?
Yes.
Everything that's essential, yes. It should be.
Is it essential to you know to know how many thrones
there? No, no. What is essential is that whether or not God is the only one that sits on a throne.
No, it doesn't matter about sitting. Why does he need to sit?
My friend.
No, no, hold on. Why does your God need to sit on the throne?
Right, I'm going
to
answer.
Why does he need to sit on the throne?
Because of what's going on here.
No, no, leave that. Why does your God have to sit on the throne?
This is the context. I can't leave it. This is what we're dealing with. This is what he's dealing with.
Okay.
My friend, what I'm saying is,
your brother just said now here that this is the throne of God.
Let's get light. Hold on, hold on. My initial trajectory on this conversation was very simple.
Yeah.
I said that Islam has more than one God.
Which
and I
lie.
Mentioned, this
the
guy
lie.
Said it's a lie.
Yeah.
I mentioned that the God of Muhammad, let's go back for everybody to get this.
Go step by step.
Yeah. Step by step. So that refresh your brain so it might help you to actually make a meaningful argument that's not going to make you come across really, really absurd to the public.
Your argument is really useless.
Because your mind is sitting on the throne, and that means it's the throne of God, that means he's God.
That was not my argument. You are speaking for me.
What is the throne?
Gabriel did not come to the prophet for some time. So one of the Quraysh women said, his Satan has deserted him. So came the divine revelation. And this is the Quran. By the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord, O Muhammad, has not forsaken nor forgotten you. So I said that one of the lords of Islam is Gabriel. So then I referred to a second hadith, which is Sahih Muslim 161D. I was called again and I looked and I saw nothing. I was called again and raised my head. And on the throne in the open atmosphere, if you look at the Arabic, it actually says in heaven, Gabriel, peace be upon him, was sitting. I began to tremble on account of fear. I came to Khadija and she said, wrap me up, wrap me up. My point was that, why is Gabriel sitting on the throne?
Okay,
that Gabriel, hold on, I'm not finished. No, because I'm going to the
Quran. Now, the word, let him bring the Arabic word. Let him bring the Arabic word. Let him bring the Arabic word first.
To prove my point, that Gabriel was the Lord of Muhammad. I went to Surah 53, verses 1 to 18. And it went like this. By the star when it descends, your companion Muhammad has not strayed or erred, nor does he speak for his inclination. It is not by revelation revealed, taught to him by one of intense strength, that is Gabriel. One of the soundless and the rose is true form. While he was in the higher part of the horizon, then he approached and descended from the throne, which is, this is the context of what I've been given.
No. Where's Jibreel?
And
where's Jibreel?
Was at the distance of 2 bar lengths and nearer, and he revealed to his servant. So now the Quran quickly says that the servant of Jibreel is Muhammad.
No.
So it that is
that.
The Quran.
No, it
say international.
So what's it, what's
for
it mean?
For those of you
mean?
That can read.
It doesn't say that. What did he say?
Maybe he knows. Maybe he knows. But he's an honest Muslim.
Listen.
This is the man that said that Allah is not the God we worship.
And
that's
true.
He drinks camel pieces.
I don't speak Arabic, so it doesn't make sense
to me. When he swear by the Najm,
well,
he knows.
We'll get Christian Prince to evaluate this video.
Read
it all in Arabic.
Read it all in Arabic.
Read it all out. So Christian Prince will translate.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. والنجم إذا هوى ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى علمه شديد القوى ذو مرة فاستوى وهو بالآفاق الأعلى ثم دنا فتدلى فكان قبا قوس أو أدنى فأوحى إلى عبده ما أوحى.
What verse did you stop at?
I stopped at 10.
No, continue.
We
didn't get to 10. We went further than 10.
Go
to 23.
أفتمارونه على ما يرى ولقد رآه نزلة أخرى عند سدرة المنتهى عندها جنة المأوى إذ يخشى السدرة ما يخشى ما زاغ البصر وما طغى لقد رأى من آيات ربه لقد رأى من آيات ربه الكبرى.
Right, which verse did you stop at?
Stop at 19.
No,
I said 23.
Go to 23. Come on.
إن هي إلا أسماء سميتموها أنتم وآباؤكم ما أنزل الله بها من سلطان إن يتبعون إلا الظن وما تهوى الأنفس ولقد جاءهم من ربهم الهدى أما الإنسان ما تمنى فلله الآخرة والأولى 30, 35 now. 12.
And which surah was that?
Surah Al-Najm.
Okay, I do not hear Alat Al-Uzza or Manat in his English translation. So we're going to have to get an Arabic speaker to confirm it. I have mad respect for you. Because you are the one of the, you are the Muslim when I quoted Surah 109 that said, the God of Islam is not the God of the Bible. And that is what I wanted, that is my mission here, to prove that the God of Islam is not the God of the Bible. And you have proved that.
We don't worship Jesus.
We don't, well and we they don't worship Muhammad. They worship Muhammad.
And no, we don't.
This is why, they were called Mohammedans for centuries. Now he's changed his mind. He's changed his mind. Twisted. Always make them slip up because liars will always get caught out. Liars always get caught out.
Specifically, I don't worship Jesus. I don't worship Muhammad.
And that is Antichrist. That is Antichrist. So on the day of judgment, the Kaaba stone is going to have ears and eyes. And it's going to testify on your behalf. Is that true?
I don't know about that hadith.
I don't know about the hadith. So why did you choose the Kaaba stone? Because it's the right hand of Allah. That is what we are on the interpretation.
We kiss the Kaaba because we saw our Prophet kissing it.
Okay,
and we know it's a stone.
Reason. You know it's a stone.
We know it's a stone. Okay. We don't worship a Kaaba.
So are you aware of that hadith that says we used to worship stones, and when we found a new or better stone, we'll milk sheep over it and then worship that new stone? That was the traditions of the Arabs beforehand. That's the same here.
They were Arab pagans.
Yes. So how come you're doing the same rituals as the Arab pagans?
No, we don't.
This is what's been confirmed by the scholars. Sorry, sir.
I'm not going to play
the hadith can come out. This is not something I'm making up. I can't call it up because I didn't prepare. The script I had was different.
Come back next week, we'll discuss it then.
I don't really want to discuss paganism because I don't see the... My view is,
what's wrong with paganism? What's wrong with paganism?
Because paganism is against the God of the Bible. The God of the Bible in Leviticus 26:1 says, do not bow to stones or worship it. That is what the Bible tells me. I can try to look at it.
Listen.
So you guys are breaking the law of Moses.
If you ask the Arab pagans, what you worshiping?
They don't exist anymore.
I'm telling you what it is, you can search it. They said we're worshiping this stone. Not because we know it's God. It's just a mediator between us and God. That's what they worship.
It's a mediator, the stone.
A mediator.
So when you kiss the Kaaba stone, how does the Kaaba stone take your sins if it's not real?
I'm going to ask you a question.
How does the stone?
When you worshiping Jesus.
I'll preach the gospel. Trust me, I'm an evangelist. I'm here to preach the gospel. And I can make sure that you love the gospel. But what I want to say is that you said that the stone is because Muhammad kissed it. But we're saying that you guys do the Hajj to kiss that stone to absorb your sin. So if the stone is not living and it's nothing real, how does the stone absorb your sin? Now explain that to me.
That is paganism.
Veneration of any object is called paganism. That is what you need an English dictionary to understand.
If I kiss my father's hand, am I worshipping my father?
No, if you kiss a stone to take away your sin, that is paganism.
That is.
You know it.
It's a large audience can see us, and I want people to go on the search. But the Muslim don't worship stones.
So what is that thing about kissing the stone?
No, the kissing the stone, we saw our Prophet doing it, and we're doing it. We're just following it. We're the follower of Muhammad.
Stone is from the heaven.
But we don't worship.
No, we don't worship.
You don't worship. But doesn't the Kaaba stone come to life and testify on the day of judgment? It does come to life. It has ears. It's going to testify. Of course, the stone is dead. I know that. So,
and the stone never
on judgment day, the stone, the Kaaba stone, will testify on behalf of Muslims. It's going to have ears and eyes. That is the truth. I'm not making this up. I don't know, because the Kaaba stone is supposed to be the right hand of Allah.
Wow.
Muslims worship more than one God. Tawheed means unification.
No.
So Jibril is on the throne of Allah, one God.
No.
Allah is another God.
No.
And the Kaaba stone is another God.
Okay.
They are polytheists.
Brother, brother. Come and
many gods?
You got more gods.
Common sense.
And Muhammad is the fourth because Allah praised to Muhammad.
Allah praise
to Muhammad. Four gods. Muslims have four gods.
Allah praise for Muhammad.
Allah praise.
Thank you, hijab. Thank you, hijab.
Thank you, hijab.
Thank you, hijab.
Thank you, hijab. Let me ask you.
Now we can talk about Jesus.
No, listen.
We all love Jesus.
So we are worshiping God, Allah. And Allah, He knows everything.
The moon God, La, La, God, La.
God knows everything.
God knows everything.
God knows everything.
He knows we worship different gods.
No. What's, God knows everything, right?
I don't think Allah does because Allah says that. Allah says meteorites.
God to you, He knows everything.
Yeah, but not your God. Allah doesn't
God
know anything.
Knows everything.
I have more brains than Allah.
To be witness on me.
I have more brains than Allah. Sorry, Allah says that women have sperm in the backbone of their ribs. I cannot take that God seriously. Allah says meteorites are shooting stars to stop shaitans from going to heaven. That is what the Quran says. Allah says in the Quran that the earth is flat and there's seven flat
earths. Definitely flat.
And the Tafsir has proved my point.
Definitely flat.
So I cannot believe Allah is God. I have no praise. NASA's debunked.
Listen. No. I can challenge him.
Are you ready to talk about Jesus?
I can challenge him. He showed me in the Quran that the earth is flat. But I can show him in the Bible.
It's flat.
You can show me in the Bible the earth is flat.
It's flat.
Show me in the Bible.
Yeah. It's about the firmament of that lot, isn't it?
This is another epic tale. I'll show you in the Bible.
Definitely flat.
We're in the Bible, Joel. The earth is
flat.
Doesn't
exist.
Doesn't exist. So give us a reference to fact check.
Isaiah 42. The circle of the earth.
Sorry? Yeah, firmament.
Yeah, you know.
Firmament. It's flat, isn't it? It's flat.
The stuff on the flat earth in the Quran, is it in that one?
I don't know if you got it.
I forgot to bring it. I didn't come prepared to bring it.
It says the earth have four corners.
No, it says the four corners of the earth. That's an allegory. All right, you know what? I don't want to get caught up into this circle of the earth thing. But if it's, I know in Job, the Lord rebukes Job at one point. And he says that, who made the firmaments and the circle of the earth? And it's also in Isaiah, but I can't just seem to find it. But the narrative, what we tried to produce before, and I want to come into conclusion on this, because this is how the Muslims are. They sneak away. They find something to detract them. He talked about the four corners of the earth, but that is an English kind of metaphor. But this brother, I'd like to introduce him. It's been a while. I met him a long time ago in Speaker's Corner, and this is the importance of our mission. He was trying to preach the gospel, but he was not a born-again Christian. And he was really trying to stand up for Christ because he was disappointed with how the Muslims... I came and gave him advice for Sister Betty. Please speak for yourself.
In a nutshell, I actually brought my son here. You didn't see him, but I brought my son here because I think it's important to be with fellow Christians and just try and get some answers, really, to questions. And I was surrounded by Muslims and they were asking me questions and I wasn't knowledge enough to give them sufficient answers. And I was trying to find the answers, but I was struggling a bit. And he sort of saw me. I don't know if he saw me struggling or if he saw me. He saw me and came to me and just said, look, just read your Bible. Really up your game. So I took that and that day I actually did nothing. You know, as a struggling Christian, I found something else to sort of bypass the time, but it really played on my mind. It was just, I just wanted to say thank you. And every day, I just, even if you read a page, two pages, you don't have to do nothing major, just try and dissect it slowly and build up. And you know, you help me a lot. And
no, God bless.
The quest continues. Definitely.
What we are trying to do as Christians, I cannot enforce my religion on you, it's faith. It's my faith we're justified, Hebrews chapter 11 or 12, if I'm correct. But this is a scripture of what brings us our belief. I use the King James Version, which is a best translation from Greek, and I'll take off. I'll not say look at all the other translations, unless you want to be a Berean and understand the greater context, and you do not follow the biblical account to the T. Please do not come here and try and get into polemics and apologetics with Muslims.
if you're going to tackle a Muslim on the Quran, make sure you've been like me that spent 10 years and lived under Sharia law and come from the Sahara, from an Islamic. A lot of Christians here make this mistake. They think they understand Islam. Islam is not a religion. If you look at the book, it's called Dawah in the West. The head scholar says Islam is not a religion, it's a deen, a way of life. I've lived under Islam. I have an Islamic name. I'm called Yaqub. My brother's called Ibrahim. I understand Islam. They are called Muhammadians. In our area, in the old days, there were Isawites, the followers of Prophet Isa and the prophets of Muhammad, and they were called Muhammadians. That is the historical narrative of Islam. To understand this, you must come from a culture that has lived with Muslims for 1,000 years, and the traditions are kept down. When you get the tradition of Hadith, that is the old ancient tradition that is passed on in the Saharan people. So we have a tradition of Hadith that comes and tells me what my ancestors did. And now we're putting them on the websites, on YouTube and etc. So please understand the deen of Islam, the five pillars they live on. If you go and start quoting the Quran, they don't read the Quran. Most of them don't know Arabic. All they know is how to do five daily prayers, do zakat, do hajj and pilgrimage, and what their parents taught them. That is the real Islam. So don't be hard on the Muslims. Understand the Bible. Bring the gospel of salvation, that Jesus Christ is God manifest in the flesh, who died on the cross and whose blood paid on the cross pays for our sins. And if you do not acknowledge that, then if you die, you are going to the eternal damnation, eternal separation from God. That is the importance of our message. We are not here to get caught up in whether you should hit a woman, or whether you should go to toilets squatting like a woman, even if you're a man, or whether we should wear women's clothes to receive divine revelations, or we should wear makeup like Muhammad. No, that is unimportant. The message is eternal salvation, because when you die, you'll be held to account by our Lord and Savior. Jesus said, all judgment has been passed on to me from the Father. Jesus is God in the flesh. That's what the Son of God means. It doesn't mean that there's a separate God. That is the God of the Quran that believes that Mary, Jesus, and Allah are three gods. The God of the Quran is stupid. If you want to be as ignorant as he is and doesn't even understand what Christianity is, then you'll go to eternal fire. A lot of Muslims might find me a bit aggressive. There's a pride in Islam. Don't be proud of stupidity. Drop your pride and read. Get knowledge. Ignorance is a disease. And the only way you can treat the disease of ignorance is by education. This is what you need to learn. God bless all the audience. And thank you, sir, for your testimony. Amen.